We're going to do about half an hour or so meditation. And please feel free to practice in whatever way you normally do. I'm going to be talking mostly about focusing on the right attitude of kindness and the way we receive experience. So that can be any experience, whether you want to work with the breath or the body sensations. But in particular, we're looking at how we relate to our experience in this meditation. So you close your eyes if that's the way you normally meditate. And just find a really comfortable position, which is fairly upright but not stiff. It's nice to check in with your body at the beginning and just see whether there's anything that needs adjusting, or that could be slightly looser. Check whether or not your spine is fairly straight. One way that you can support the spine is to just gently lift the knees and tilt the pelvis slightly. Roll the shoulders back a little bit. And just feel that extension in the spine. So it was reaching up towards the ceiling, through the back of the head. You may find it's nice to balance the head slightly forward. And just notice the body sitting. Seeing it from the inside with kindly eyes, the way you'd look upon a good friend. See if you can sense the support around you in this room. The beautiful shape of the room seems to hold the energy. And all the people who are here with us today, spiritual companions for a day of quiet. And just get a real sense of appreciation for being here with ourselves, with each other. No one's judging us. No one expects anything of us today. We don't need to expect anything of ourselves. The most important thing is not what arises in our field of awareness, but how we relate to that. How much kindness and care we can give to that experience. It may help to imagine that awareness is like the light of a sun, bringing things into our perceptive field. And kindness is like the warmth of that sun, warming, relaxing, holding it gently in kindness. and establishing a beautiful intention. May I care for this experience. May awareness become a medium through which I can channel kindness. And noticing the effect of that softness and that kindness. Gentle attention on experience itself. If you feel the mind contracting or tightening around any experience, see if you can soften the edges. Maybe widen the attention in that area. Adding kindness. Whilst listening in more deeply. Feeling in more fully to the experience. behind any thoughts that come in and disturb the mind. Notice if you can slightly shift your attention to allow them to go to the edges of the screen of the mind. Not giving them too much attention or importance. Noticing the space between those thoughts. The beautiful silence of this pleasant moment. Noticing and appreciating, giving kindness to that silence, to that contentment which is there in the mind. If you feel you want a bit more focus, then ask the mind, does it want to be aware of the body and the sensations? Or would it like to invite the breath to come in? if the breath does come in, treat it like a friend. With great care and gentleness. As though you were holding a very delicate little bird. If you hold it too tightly, you'll crush the bird. Too loose and it'll fly away. So just experiment with what kind of attention you need to invite the breath or the sensations in. Tending to each and every moment. Each moment of mindfulness is a moment of retreat. Valuing each moment, treating it with kindness, and noticing the beauty in the simple present moment. So we're coming towards the end of the meditation, but before we finish and open our eyes, it can be helpful to just review what happened. What was the effect of adding kindness to the mindfulness? What led to the undermining of the unwholesome states and to the increase of the wholesome states? And how do I feel now? How much more calmness, peace and clarity do I have in my mind? So however much peace and calm you've developed, just take a few moments to really value and appreciate that. Feeding the good wolf, watering the flowers. Now let your attention come back out from the body and gently expand into the room, picturing in your mind's eye all the people sitting here with us and holding them in kindness, with kindly eyes. So that at the end of the third ring of the gong, we can slowly open our eyes and come out of the meditation. Does everybody here know a little bit about walking meditation, or shall we just do a little practice, just at least to get up on our feet and just experiment with how that feels? So walking meditation is one of the postures that the Buddha praised. And it's a more dynamic style of meditation. But the idea is that the body and the mind walk together. So often in life our mind is a few steps ahead of our body, or sometimes the body is ahead and our mind doesn't quite know where it's going yet. So here we want to bring the mind into the body and for the two to move in harmony. So it doesn't really matter how fast you walk or how slow, but make sure it's comfortable. And the purpose of this meditation is usually just coming to more awareness of the body. You can also include looking at the volition behind the movement. And this helps us to see that it's not the self that's moving the body, but that it's
causally arisen from volition. So, you know, the body can't move without us making some kind of will for the foot to move. So that's also something that can be quite nice to notice. But if you prefer just to stay with the feelings, that's great. And while you're standing, you can just practice shifting weight from one foot to the next and see how that feels. Noticing the sensations in the bottom of the feet. If you want to take a step, noticing how the foot moves, lifts, comes down onto the floor. Which part of the foot touches the floor first. How the weight moves over. How much there is to see and to notice. So again, choose your own speed and make use of the lovely areas outside. And we'll have lunch at about 12:10. So you've got almost half an hour. You're also welcome to stay here if you want.